So in the last week or so, most of the polls that have come out have been pretty good for Bernie Sanders. So that has increased his chances of winning the nomination per our forecast. And I think where you're particularly seeing that is in some of the early state polls, Iowa and New Hampshire especially. Basically, every poll that has come out in the last week or so in New Hampshire has shown Sanders up by at least five, if not low double digits, 10, 12 points. And so that has definitely helped him, though I should say that New Hampshire has in the past at times surprised people. In the 2008 primary, for example, Barack Obama won a really close race in Iowa. Heading into New Hampshire, he was leading in the polls there. And then Hillary Clinton won a very narrow win in New Hampshire, despite the polls having Obama ahead. So we shouldn't exactly count on New Hampshire to do precisely what we think it will do. But given that Sanders is from there, he won big there in 2016 in the Democratic primary, you'd think, given where he's at in the polls and that history and the fact he's from next door in Vermont, that he'd be in a good position. But in Iowa also, Sanders had actually had a couple polls that weren't very good for him that had come out a week and a half or so ago, 2 weeks ago. But now Sanders and Biden are basically tied in our polling average with about 22 to 23% for both of them. And then if you look at our forecast, which brings in some other things to consider as well, both of them have about a 1-in-3 shot of winning the most votes in Iowa. If you're taking them together, if he wins Iowa plus New Hampshire, that would set him up historically to be in a very good position to win the nomination. Basically, since Iowa became important, which goes back to the 1976 caucuses with Jimmy Carter's kind of out-of-nowhere rise all the way to the Democratic nomination, no candidate has won both contests and then failed to win the nomination on the Democratic side. So you'd be really running against history for Sanders to not win the nomination. Now, it's given the rules on the Democratic side, very proportional delegate allocation, and also the fact that Sanders is definitely not a favorite of a lot of people in the Democratic Party establishment, it would be very interesting to see where the race went from there. But at least historically, Sanders would be in a pretty good spot. I'm Jeffrey Skelly, and I'm an elections analyst at 538.